Thank you. Cody.
I love your band. You guys just have so much energy.
Thanks. Well, that's what we go for. It's like moshing.
We're young and not jaded yet.
Yeah. Hopefully you'll never lose that energy. So where did you guys get the name from? Where did it come from? Like, where did the name come from? How did you guys think about it?
My brother actually, his name's Mike. He was one time, I think, maybe in a slightly altered mindset and called me and it mentioned, because we were all trying to think of a band name, we didn't have one for like a year, and then he called me and said we should name it Solar Slaughter as a joke, but we actually found it to be kind of cool.
Yeah, that's
kind
of cool. Does it have any meaning? Because when I think of slaughter, I think of slaughtering.
Yeah, you could think of it that way.
Slaughtering solar line.
Sounds good.
Yeah, it doesn't always have to be
slaughtering
kind of
solar system.
Or else you could just be like, solar and slaughter. Like two separate things.
Yeah.
Just however you want it. Just depends on how you're looking at it, I guess.
Fairly out of this thing, slaughtering things. Yeah. I guess it all depends on the moon, too.
Oh.
Yeah. I like
the
name.
Things get slaughtered in a solar system. It's not that big.
It works itself out on a cosmic level.
That's a lot better than my cosmic. So, your songs, where do they come from?
Mainly these two guys write them.
Same.
And then. And they just kind of come at me, and I'll just throw some drum beats over it, and he usually just writes some lyrics.
Yeah.
So it's a collaboration of all of you guys.
Yeah.
Well, for and we just got Cody about.
Yeah.
I don't know, like a couple ago, something like
couple
that.
Couple shows ago.
We've been three shows and two band practices. So
oh wow.
Trying.
You fit right in.
Yeah. It's pretty sweet.
Yeah. You mesh all together. How did you guys meet?
We all went to school.
We all been G since like.
Yeah.
Middle school.
Yeah, I had fucking Rampage and shit too.
Yeah.
I was like best friends with his older brother there. That's how I knew all these guys. I played another band with Rick called Sarcophagus. We play like once a year. It's in a basement somewhere with a bunch of crust punks usually, so it's a good time.
Sometimes it's better because then the crust comes out because you're
pretty,
once a year.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah. Everyone has fun when everyone's like shit trashed and on the street.
So you guys all know your secrets because you guys grew up together, so that's
pretty good. Yeah. We know each other pretty well. Like, me and Ray played football for like years.
We've been best buddies since like sixth graders or seventh graders.
The history behind the band.
Yeah.
That's cool. Who are your influences?
Deeds of Flesh.
For some reason.
Necrophages, Slayer.
Dying Fetus.
Suffocation.
Demolition Hammer.
Demolition.
Yeah. Let's play Pool.
Warbringer. Let's play Pool.
Leonard Skinner.
Morbid Angel. Metallica, Violence.
Did they ever say
Violator?
Did they ever say Slayer yet?
Yeah, Slayer.
I know so many.
Slayer. Slayer!
I played a drinking game once, where every time someone said Slayer, you had a drink. So we had just a whole room of people yelling Slayer and then drinking.
That must have been an interesting night.
Yeah.
So where do you guys see yourself going, or where do you guys want to go?
We're just trying to like chill and write songs and shred and just play around. We're not trying to like get signed really or get big. We're just trying to shred and hang out.
Shred. Have fun.
Yeah. Play some shows and stuff. Muck around.
Yeah, try to muck around.
Try to muck around.
Maybe try to slime a little tour in the summer or something.
Yeah.
Or
swap a clock.
Yeah.
Your genre, how would you guys classify that?
Tech death.
Yeah.
Death metal.
I used to
be
tech death.
Brutal death metal.
Yeah. Swamp.
Yeah. Swamp Womp Frog?
Basically, Swamp Core.
Death Metal Monk.
Monk. It's the Monk.
It's like. It's Sludge, is what it is.
It's Sludge Monk Core. Death.
It's a little bit of everything, I guess, I'll say. I like that, though. I like that, the way you classify that. That's, it describes your band pretty good. Because
I like
you guys, when you guys are all up there, you can see the influences coming through.
Yeah, we're just. Try to write some shreds that can get people
moving
and pumped up.
Gosh,
adrenaline.
Some of the songs that you guys play tonight, where did the ideas come from?
Probably him sitting in his room playing guitar for like 6 hours a day.
And that and us just
you smoke
playing
a lot
guitar.
Meditation.
Yeah, just trying to get shit straight and write some good shreds.
Yeah. We're just trying to shred.
So it sounds like you guys are being creative all the time, so that's always good.
Yeah.
Any upcoming shows that are coming up?
Yeah, we're playing with Invidiosis, who is just played right now and was awesome. We're playing with them in Mankato March 21st. Yes, that is. What else is on that show?
Enabler.
Yeah, Enabler. Enabler's
oh, sick. What's Up Lounge?
Yeah, the What's Up Lounge. Yeah, Enabler's playing. They're sick.
Climatic.
Watch times.
Human bashing.
That's pretty fun. Yeah. Urban Mankato's got a really good death metal scene down there.
No, it's our
first they're for show.
We played. Wait, what?
Not Mankato.
Actually,
I went there for a show once, and the guy at the Herbs and Gerbs knew who In Defense was, and I thought that was really cool.
So you guys are going to have a good time.
Oh, yeah, that should be a good time.
Yeah. It is a smaller bar, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really small.
I think it's like a little bit bigger than this room.
We did Face of Oblivion there.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool though.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with a small bar.
No,
that's the way to go. Small venues are the best. Basement shows and stuff like that. I've always had the most fun house shows, basement shows. You get a lot more energy that way.
Yeah.
Can't get kicked out by security. And
you do what you want.
Yeah.
Interact with your fans a little bit more. Mm-hmm.
Accumulate the most modest sludge as possible.
Yeah.
Yes.
Most amount of muck.
We want as much muck as possible.
Coming this summer, Muck a Swampolis, you heard it here first.
Yeah.
I don't know. We're gonna be going into the studio quick with Steve Lane, Nine Oak Studios, to do a little two song, a little single out, and then later this summer we're probably gonna do a short EP or something like that.
That's
the plan right now. We don't really got a whole lot going right now for recordings.
Yeah, the recordings that we do have that are on our Facebook and whatnot.
It's in your basement.
Yeah, we recorded in my basement.
They're really quiet.
Yeah. They
were. They were.
And it was free, so.
That was
pretty awesome.
Where can your fans find you?
We got Facebook,
probably.
You guys,
Facebook.
Yeah,
yes,
Facebook
we have
a
fan
Twitter,
page.
John.
Yo, I'm not a administrator anymore, so. you guys can talk about Facebook.
It's so
sounds like there's a story behind that, but I won't even ask.
I don't know.
Facebook, okay. Yeah. Merchandise? Do you guys have merchandise?
We got these shirts that were printed incorrectly, so we're just like trying to get rid of them, so they're not for sale for like $5.
Yeah.
So.
And if you're poor, we'll
just give
probably
you
get
yeah,
it to you.
They don't want one really bad, they just couldn't have one.
So what happened? What's incorrect about it?
The back. We were supposed to have like a mucky, like, ooze writing, but it ended up just being like
college letters,
like half capital font. The other one would be like lower.
I just knew bad Minnesota death metal and like all lowercase, and then
that's
like the original.
Well, we got them for free because he screwed them up.
Well, that's cool.
And then we got the right ones.
Yeah, those are all bad. So we only have the shitty ones right now.
You guys
should
wear it in the show and then throw them up to the audience.
Get one of those t-shirt guns that they got at like fucking NASCAR and stuff like that.
That would be cool.
Just jot up there with a t-shirt gun and shoot into the pit with the fucking t-shirt gun.
That would be kind of awesome.
Where do you get one of those? Amazon?
Just just make potato guns.
Yeah, it'd be slime
field. Put some like
Nickelodeon
slime t-shirts in there and just slime everyone while we give them shirts.
Slime time.
Slime time.
You're gonna have to video that.
Oh,
yeah. So
let's see what else. Oh, Fanny's gonna miss the slime. I always go so fast. I don't understand why I always go so fast. But thank you so much for letting us interview you.
No problem.
Of course. Thanks for interviewing and filming.
Yeah!
Solar Slatter!
Solar Slatter!
Solar Slatter!
Thanks,
Remember,
thank you.
Facebook!
Thank you. so long.